There is great hope on the part of the fans. This is a very good team, a very promising playoff future. Hello, everybody. Gary Thorne, delighted to have you with us tonight. They are the defending champions in a must-win situation if that defense of the cup is to continue.
The top-seeded Shockers entered the game as overwhelming favorites, having won four consecutive championships with a combination of skill, thuggery, and the unwavering support of the referee. The third-seed Wildfire entered the game as massive underdogs. Not only did they drop their previous matchup against the Shockers 6-1, star center and leading scorer Will Bentley was lost for the season to a knee injury. Despite the long odds, the Wildfire come out swinging and land the first punch. Defenseman Jared Cameron jumps up to lead the rush and the Shocker goalie inadvertently deflects it off Cameron into his own net for a stunning goal.
Slide his stick out, and it hit his stick, Carroll back through the legs, and you can see his reaction.
Oh my gosh.
The Wildfire control the first period, peppering the Shocker goal with shots and sustained offensive pressure, while clogging the center of the ice. The few times the Shockers mount a counter-attack, goalie Micah Michalski shuts the door with authority.
Up the middle and goal, breaks to the net.
Outstanding goaltending.
That'll help his confidence moving forward.
Frustrated, the Shockers resort to their usual goon behavior and lash out. Shocker man beast number 19 blatantly boards Wildfire winger Sam Fong, but the referee ignores the foul.
I mean, this is as dirty as it gets in hockey.
Already leading by one, the Wildfire strike again. This time second-line center Kyle Bendel beat the Shockers to the puck with his speed. Then stick handled away from two defenders before feeding a blind pass to wing Bronco. Bronco knocked over a defender to create space and immediately fired on net.
Fires! He scores! Wow!
Just like that, the good guys led 2-0 over the forces of evil.
From just above the goal line, finds an opening.
Finds a little room, and then just looks and fires.
Leading 2-0 with a Wildfire have a chance to salt the game away, but cannot capitalize on a power play. The Wildfire continued to generate scoring chances and appeared to have the game well in hand, but then a series of questionable penalty calls dulled their momentum. Three times the ref sent Wildfire skaters to the box for a Shocker power play, including a 5-on-3. And yet the Wildfire bravely hung on, blocking shots, and repelling wave after wave of Shocker attackers. By the start of the third period, the weary Wildfire, worn down by killing off three consecutive penalties, retreat into a defensive shell. It will prove to be their undoing. Disaster inevitably strikes when a bad bounce squirts through the slot and into the net. The Shockers narrow the deficit to 2-1. Emboldened by their first goal, the Shockers and the forces of Lucifer start to gain momentum. They amp up their thuggery, while the officials, inexplicably, ignore the blatant fouls.
That is intentional, that is cheap, that is outside the rules of the game.
Now an opportunity, scores! Ties the game in two!
Wow, absolutely incredible turn of events here.
With two goals in just under 4 minutes, the Shockers tie the score and reclaim all momentum. Bruised and deflated, the Wildfire soldier on. But the collapse is all but inevitable. The Shockers put the nail in the coffin with a garbage goal with just under 3 minutes left to play. True to form, they do it in cheap shot fashion, when their player hacks the glove out of goalie Michalski's hand. The goal is soul-crushing. the valiant Wildfire mount one final charge, but it's to no avail. Their dreams of a championship are extinguished.
Came out flying. They played the body. They forechecked intensely, and for most of the game, they dominated. But the third periods have not been friendly, and this one exploded in their faces.
Your time!